was in the new oven, take a picture of the
oven. Tag your BFF who's gotta take a pic of her food before she eats it and say, this you? I'll tell you one thing, it sure me.
Hey, real talk though, in my car, I got snacks. Would you mind getting my snacks for me?
Huh? No.
Here's what we're talking about today. The Free Britney drama is at an all-time high. Britney Spears sent her sister, Jamie Lynn, a cease and desist. Call Her Daddy fans have turned on host Alex Cooper and are calling for her cancellation. Is Pete Davidson scared after Kanye West threatened to beat him up? Leonardo DiCaprio is making false claims about climate change. Again, Michael Phelps is a coward, and I've got the pop culture rewind. See, it's a lot of stuff. I'm Alex Clark, and this is Poplogics. Every time I open Instagram, I swear, Britney has posted another scathing drag of her little sister.
Stop making that face at me. I hate that face.
This is my only face. I don't have a lot of faces.
In the middle of Jamie Lynn's media tour about her new book, Britney's lawyer sent her a cease and desist, warning her to stop talking about Britney to promote the book, even if the book technically isn't about Britney. She's just talking about her in the interviews.
When comes along, you must zip it. Zip it good.
The letter says publicly airing false or fantastical grievances is wrong, especially when designed to sell books. It is also potentially unlawful and defamatory. It goes on to demand she cease and desist from referencing Britney derogatorily during your promotional campaign. If you fail to do so or defame her, Britney will be forced to consider and take all appropriate legal action. Ooh, do you think that's fair? Jamie Lynn isn't the only person getting fallout from this media tour she's on for her book either. Because Alex Cooper from Call Her Daddy interviewed her this week, fans are turning on her and saying her show should be canceled.
Let's get into it.
Okay.
You have a text message that clears your name from your sister. Can you pull out your phone and read that recent text from Britney?
Do I have my phone?
Hold on to your bigger seat, that seat right here.
She says to me.
The Jamie Lynn interview was supposed to be a two-parter, but now it looks like the video promoting the second half of the podcast has been deleted from the Call Her Daddy Instagram. It could be because of the cease and desist, or it could be because Alex is getting so much hate. 99% of the comments under it were negative. Meanwhile, The Sun is claiming that Oprah will do Britney's first sit-down televised interview. Please, 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 please be the case. I want to host a huge watch party at TPUSA headquarters if that happens. Would that be fun?
Britney unfollowed Jamie Lynn on Instagram. She recently referred to her as a mean ass.
Kanye West and The Game released a song last week, and in it, Kanye threatens to beat up Pete Davidson. He raps, "God save me from that crash, just so I can beat Pete Davidson's ass." I love that Dr. Seuss poem. In 2002, Kanye was in a bad car accident, if you didn't know, that left him with a broken jaw.
One thing I know, my girl ain't no hobbit. She might be stumpy, that don't mean she a hobbit.
An insider told Page Six, Pete thinks it's totally hilarious. And not just that, he thinks the whole tabloid drama with him, Kanye, and Kim is hilarious. He loves it.
I want to fight you.
The source went on to say that it's funny to him that the press wants to know his every move all of a sudden, and that the whole craziness with Kanye last week has brought Kim and Pete closer.
Nothing I am doing is working.
You know Ashley Iconetti and Jared Haben from Bachelor in Paradise? They're pregnant with their first baby, and they're naming him Dawson after Leonardo DiCaprio's character, Jack Dawson, in Titanic. If you know them at all, you know they are obsessed with movie references, so I actually love this. It's too bad Leonardo DiCaprio isn't more like Jack Dawson and less like himself, because Leo is kind of a tubby idiot now. In a recent Deadline interview, he falsely claimed that the United States per capita is the largest polluter in the world. This, of course, is a blatant lie. Data shows that China is actually the number one emitter of CO2 in the world per capita. He He also said we only have 9 years left because of climate change. I have deja vu.
The world is gonna end in 12 years if we don't address climate change.
Oh no! If the world ends in 9 years, little Dawson may have to reenact the end scene of Titanic and hold on for dear life as Earth's pollution takes over. Let's hope Rose will leave room for him on that door.
Ate too many beignets. My butt's too big for you to fit.
That moment when Michael Phelps is asked point blank about transgender people competing in women's sports, and this is what he has to say.
Because it has to be a level playing field. I think that's something that we all need. Because it's that's what sports are. And for me, I don't know where this is going to go. I don't know what's going to happen. I believe that we all should feel comfortable with who we are in our own skin. But I think sports should all be played at an even playing field. I don't know what that looks like in the future. But it's hard. I don't know.
It's
what
complicated.
To say. It's very complicated.
It's very complicated. People should feel comfortable in their own skin, but sports should be an even playing field.
Oh, you almost had it. You gotta be quicker than that.
It's actually not complicated at all, Michael. He knows it's wrong by admitting sports should be an even playing field, but was too cowardly to come right out and say it's unfair, it's wrong, and it needs to stop. Sounds like just another athlete appealing to the mob.
You find little tiny girl balls that are so f***ing tiny and shriveled up. Let me know.
Are you curious about what happened this week in pop culture history? Well, my darling, step into my little pink time machine and let's find out. This is the Pop Culture Rewind. This week in 1953, Lucy on I Love Lucy had a baby, and over 70% of the country's TVs were watching. Never before had anyone been pregnant or had a baby on TV. Lucy and her husband even slept in separate beds on the show. This whole thing was extremely scandalous in 1953.
Honey, no.
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell me?
Why, you didn't give me a chance.
Are you kidding?
No.
It's me!
In 1998, this week, for the first time, everyone found out about the Monica Lewinsky-Bill Clinton affair because it was published by conservative Matt Drudge on the Drudge Report.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman, Miss Lewinsky. I never told anybody to lie, not a single time, never. These allegations are false, and I need to go back to work for the American people.
Then, in 2003 this week, Chappelle's show debuted on Comedy Central.
Anyhow, here with the weather is our old pal, reliable, friendly, portly, Big Al.
Happy Reparations Day. Happy Juneteenth. Just kidding. Chuck, I don't know if you know this, but I just handed in my resignation here at News Center 3 hours ago. And I'll tell you something else you probably didn't know. And that is this. This is not my real speaking voice.
Actually, Chuck, this is my real speaking voice. I talk like straight up gangster, bitch.
And in 2006 this week, High School Musical was broadcast on the Disney Channel.
I thought I could feel a bug.
It isn't a bug. Now you just thought it was something, girl.
I just thought it was
something cool.
And that's what happened this week in pop culture history. Tonight, the DJ's gonna fall in love with me again. I definitely butchered those lyrics. No, tonight at midnight Eastern, a brand new episode of The Spillover drops on Apple Podcasts and Spotify. Hint, it is a celebrity guest who you guys tagged in the comments telling them to come on the show. Yes, our little experiment worked. Even I can't believe it. At 9 p.m. Eastern, right here on the Poplitics Instagram, we will announce who it is. Who's your guest, though? Cookie Monster! No, not Cookie Monster. Heart this episode of Poplitics. Discuss in the comments if you think Britney cease and desist is fair, what you think of the name Dawson for a boy, and what you think the best Disney Channel original movie is. The right answer is My Date with the President's Daughter. If you know, you know, and if you don't, you don't. DM this episode to one friend and just say, you're a potato, nothing else. And hit that save button. You should know this by now because it gives the episode superpowers in the algorithm. We're back tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific, and trust me, out of all the Poplitics episodes we've ever done, tomorrow's especially is one you are not going to want to miss. It'll be smashing. Pop culture without the propaganda every single day. I'm Alex Clark, and this is Poplitics. Support Poplitics, the first ever conservative pop culture daily show, by subscribing to our channel, turning on notifications, and of course, hitting the thumbs up. Also, our main home is on Instagram. Seriously, just trust me, that's where the real magic happens. Follow us there at Poplitics.